I think, a driver for why my brother and myself have wanted to go back and rediscover our family legacy, is that it was such a mystery to us. I'm in the fortunate position of being a fifth generation soap maker. We have inherited a company from Dr. Bronner, who himself was a third generation soap maker from a German Jewish soap making family.
I'm Lotte Reches, born Heilbronner from the town Heilbronn in Württemberg. My grandfather was in Laubheim. No, Laubheim is a small town. So, they make soap and candles. Jews are lighting candles every Friday evening. And this is a byproduct of the soap making. So they were all living from this work.
In 1858 was when the Master Soap Making Certificate was issued to Emanuel Heilbronner. And he first established a soap making factory in the basement of his house. You know, just was a real successful family enterprise. Actually, the Heilbronner family invented liquid soap, and the Heilbronner family went on to establish two more factories, the most important of which was in Heilbronn. And we visited Heilbronn. We went to visit the Jewish cemeteries in both Heilbronn and Laubheim. There's memorials to the Jewish war dead of World War I. And just realizing just what the German Jewish experience was, we visited Heilbronn, visited the old soap factory, which is now a machine shop. The Nazis took it, and the Nazis was all very legalistic. You know, the forced sale of Jewish property to Nazis. You know, and it was very disturbing. And when Laubheim, we were the Jewish quarter. You know, it's just like the Nazis' granddaughter, I believe, now lives there. And she's a sweet old lady, but you know, it's just kind of crazy. You know, just a really intense experience. But it was really wonderful how the town really showed up and took us through it. And Laubheim especially really done a good job showing the local history, the local Jewish history. So visiting the Jewish graveyard, seeing our old, you know, our ancestors.
My brother Jim is another symbol of how God blessed our family with each one of us having a special trait. Jim became the basic chemist for the company and kept the soap at the level it's always been, one of the finest.
When he first found his father after getting out of the Navy, he helped him mix the soap, which he would rent a facility on Saturdays and ship it to his dad in bulk. Eventually wound up being technical director and up to vice president of this particular facility, always making his dad soap. But now it wasn't done just on a rented Saturday, it was part of their production.
My brother, more than me, took over the business sense. He ended up patenting a snow foam for special effects in movies and a foam both made from bubbles. That was incredible improvement for fighting fires. And when Dad died, there was a smile on his face, knowing that the business would continue.
Soapmaker Bronner became a rabbi to teach the moral ABC, knowing the full truth that unites all. We're all one, all one, all one!
Our company is unique, thanks to Dr. Bronner, in being a very progressive engine. Dr. Bronner was very urgent in his belief that if humanity doesn't get over the trivial differences that divide us, that we are going to destroy ourselves.
One of the driving passions for my grandfather was the soap and, more importantly, the label. And he put everything he had into the label. For him, it was a very spiritual message meant to break down religious barriers and find the essence of God, as well as it was a social construct of how we can get along with people who don't necessarily share our same religious cultural beliefs and find our common ground.
My father's big achievement, and it was the reason for all the words on the label, could be summed up with the statement, "We are all brothers and sisters because of one eternal, ever-loving Father. We should care for each other and this planet." And David made that meaningful by going into fair trade all over the earth. We are helping turn the earth around. Instead of, for example, the farmers getting 10 cents an hour or meaningless money from the billion-dollar corporations, we are now dealing with the family farm and the co-op that processes the raw material. And David went out of his way to see that we have Palestinian olive oil, fair traded, Castile, natural, organic, in our soaps. From a corporate view, it was not the cheapest. From a helping the earth view, it was incredible.
Fair trade is a concept, I think, it's like, you know, melds beautifully with mission of how do we improve the world situation, you know, which is very much, I think, what our label's about. And then it's very much also about just having immediate relationships with the people closest to the earth that are supplying the materials that are making your product.
You know, I am absolutely amazed what has happened to Dr. Bronner's since David and Michael have been at the helm.
What this generation is doing is we're taking those fundamentals that my grandfather talked about, taking those environmental ideals, the social ideals that he talked about, and we're applying them to the earth around us. We're applying them to reality and trying to make this business serve those ideals that my grandfather put on a label.